My name is James, and this is Raising Your IT IQ. By now, you've probably heard about multi-factor authentication, or MFA for short. If you aren't sure what MFA is, it's basically a lock and key system for internet accounts. When you sign into an account on one device, like your computer, that would be the lock. It sends a code to a second device, like a phone or iPad, which would act as the key. It may sound complicated, but it's pretty easy to set up. I'm going to show you how to set up two methods of multi-factor authentication for your PBSC account. The first by Microsoft Authenticator app and the second by phone. I highly suggest you set up both methods and set the app as a default. And I'll show you how to do that later. But for now, let's do the initial setup. Now, after you've gone through the initial process of creating a password for your Palm Beach State account, you're going to want to log in with your email address. Now, if you're a student, you want to make sure you put @my.palmbeachstate.edu. If you're faculty or staff, don't put my, just @palmbeachstate.edu. All right, so we'll click on next. And you'll put in your password here. Now, when you put your email address, you're going to see this box that says more information required. So all you have to do is click on next. It's going to tell you to start by downloading the app. So the first thing you're going to want to do is open up the App Store. And this will be the same on Android devices. You'll just open up the Google Play Store. You want to tap on search. You want to search for Microsoft Authenticator. All right, now tap on Microsoft Authenticator. Don't get the one that says Authenticator app. You want to get the one that says Microsoft Authenticator. So I'll open that up since I've already downloaded it. Now, after I've downloaded it, I'm going to click on next. Then I'm going to click on add account on the phone. And I'm going to select work or school account. And then here, I'm going to click on next on the computer. And then on the app, I'm going to select scan QR code. So I want to point my camera at the QR code on the computer. And now it adds my account right into the authenticator. So I want to click on next. And now what it's doing is it's sending me a number. And now on the phone, I have to type that number in, 64. Tap on yes. And now my account is set up on the authenticator app. So I click on next on the computer. Now we're going to set up the second method of authentication through the phone call. And so what I'll do is I'll just enter my phone number in here and I'll click on next. All right, now it's going to call my phone.
This is Microsoft sign-in system. If you are trying to sign in, press the pound key to finish signing in.
All right, so I'm going to open up my keypad and I'm going to press the pound key.
Your sign-in was successfully verified. Goodbye.
And now I have my phone number set up on the authentication. So I just click on next and now I click on done. Now, once I'm in the email, I'm going to click on my profile icon here. Then I'm going to click on view account. And then I want to click on update info in the security info box. And then here it'll show you what your default method is. For me, it's set as the Microsoft Authenticator. If you want to change that, you can click on change and change it to the phone. But I recommend leaving it on the Microsoft Authenticator app. The reason for that is if you are on the phone with me or somebody else from student support and they ask you to log into your account, instead of having to wait for a phone call, switch over, do the code, and then switch back, you can just pull out your phone and tap on the screen and authenticate that way. So let's say it sent me a sign-in request, but let's say I'm in an area where I'm just not able to use the app for whatever reason. What I can do is I can click on, I can't use my Microsoft Authenticator app right now. So now I can select call and it'll call my phone. Press pound and it'll let me in. And that's all there is to it, to setting up multi-factor authentication for your Palm Beach State account. If you need any extra help or need more information, you can call the IT service desk at 561-868-4000 and they'd be happy to assist you. That's all I have for this episode of Raising Your IT IQ. My name is James and I will see you in the next one.